the church. And negative news shocks and offends faster than people who see faith. It's like going to the conference. They don't take their eyes off it. That's good for their business. But it's not good for you. Now, mind you, I would tell you that this doesn't mean that you're going to get torn. It's important that you get torn. And what happens is most of us get so glued to it that we get so caught up in it, we are there way beyond getting torn. Now, if you don't believe me when I say that this has a big impact on your ability to remain positive and optimistic, looking forward to the future, try this out. Well, those mornings when you wake up and you're feeling pretty good, turn on the news. All you need is 5 minutes. See what happens. See if you feel better about your life or worse. It happens that quickly. So go on a media dump. It doesn't mean that you starve yourself. It just means be careful about what you eat. The next thing. That strategy is be grateful. I'm going to be honest with you. Nobody in here is living in Darfur. Nobody in here is in Haiti right now. Get a grip. Really. This is a room full of well-fed, well-clothed, and well-housed human beings. We have opportunities and capabilities that are what 95% of the world has available. So come on. Stop it. Be grateful. There is so much for you to be grateful for in your life. Focus on that, and I will tell you, focus there, you're going to start seeing yourself being grateful. A lot better about the money. The next thing is be generous. Now, generosity doesn't just mean writing big checks. If you can do that, by all means, do it. There are a lot of people who can use it. But generosity comes in a lot of sorts and sizes. Generosity is about generosity of spirit. What if it's you being generous with who you are? What if you are operating in a way that just by the interaction that you have with someone, their day is better. They feel better about themselves. That's generosity, too. When you think about giving of yourself in a way that has a very impactful effect on those around you, being generous takes the pressure off you and puts it squarely on your mind. Next one, that uses love. And any of you out here have clients who have been scared to death. So the problem happens, and fear is a funny thing. Fear resides in the limbic part of the brain, the emotional part of the brain. And how it continues and gets into a groove and it stays there and deepens and deepens is because it is memory specific. Well, what if this happens? Well, what if it does? Name it. Get specific with it and move that part of that emotional part of the brain into the neocortical part of the brain, which is the logical part of the brain, so you can apply strategy. So as soon as you make that shift, as soon as you take it in a non-generalized, non-specific, make it specific, you can apply strategies. You can get in action. And when people have strategies and they have a path and they have actions that they can take, much of the fear disappears. And here's another thing that happens when you go through this, is that oftentimes those fears are completely unfounded. There's nothing there. It's all smoke. So when you go through the exercise, say, what do you feel? What do you think about? What are you worried about? What does that happen? Then what would you do? because if there is a risk, then we want to make sure that people are actually doing what they need to do to take care of the situation. And if it's not out there, we want to get rid of it. So what if? And the last strategy I want to share with you about this today is stay up to your counsel. I cannot tell you how many advisors I have seen over the last year or two who have gone heading for the hills, hiding under their desks, out of communication with their clients. They're so afraid to say anything that's bad that's been going on that they've been out of communication, that it's said nothing wrong. And clients are leaving those advisors in droves. They're looking for other advisors who will talk to them. Be in communication. Now, more than ever before, be in communication. Talk to people. Do not just talk about anything. Talk to them about things that are relevant to their lives. Talk to them about things that are important to them. And this may surprise you, but the things that people want to know the most about isn't what's happening with the TLC. They have no idea what that means. And besides, they get that information fast and accurate. So data is not the kind of communication that I'm talking about. Data is not what I'm speaking about. I'm speaking about things that are relevant to people's lives. Give them the context. How do they think about what's going on? What's important in their lives, and how can you help them with that? So it may have nothing to do with financial information. It may just be either listening to them or sending them information that is useful and relevant to their lives. But the most important thing is to be in communication. Don't come out of your friends, don't come out of your debts. There's a different way of communicating, and I believe very, very strongly that passion and the corresponding conviction that comes from passion is one of the most important differentiators that you have available to you in your businesses. It is so important. No one willing to actually put a stake in the ground that when you are the one doing that, it's differentiated from everybody else. So that is, I believe, that passion and conviction is at the core of all powerful communication. And that may be bad news for a number of you because you may have forgotten why you